Welcome, everybody, to Life is Strange. Indeed, life is strange. When is life ever not strange? Wow, that's... Wow, fucking... Big brain. Welcome to Life is Strange, everybody. This is a game that I have never played, nor have I ever seen. Which is surprising because this is a very popular game. I remember when it first came out, everybody was talking about it, and everybody was playing it on YouTube. And somehow, I have not gotten spoiled for a single thing. So, this is going to be a first-time epic gamer playthrough. For me. Not from anybody else, because they've already played through the game 100 times. Anyways, let's continue. Screen size, yes. That is indeed my screen size. Alright. Ready to play, ladies and gentlemen?
Let's hop into it.
Life is Strange is a story-based game that features player choice. The consequences of all your in-game actions and decisions will impact the past, present, and future. Choose wisely. Is this like one of the Telltale games? This isn't a Telltale game, right? I hope not. Oh, Jesus Christ! Help! 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 Jesus! Help! Ah!
Help! Help! It's so loud! My ears!
You're in a hurricane.
I'm trapped in a storm. How did I get here? And where is here?
Good question. Welcome to Kansas.
Wait, there's the lighthouse. I'll be safe if I can make it there. I hope. Please let me make it there.
Okay, lady. I know that you are in peril right now, but I need to lower your volume by about 80%. Jesus Christ. That hurt. That hurt my damn ears.
Hello? Hello?
All right. The lighthouse. Ah, yes. Clearly it says lighthouse. I think it may be this way.
Help.
Dear Lord. Quick. We gotta make it. I don't want to go to the Land of Oz. The Land of Oz, the Land of Oz, that is where Dorothy went. I don't want to live in Kansas anymore. The Wicked Witch of the West? More like the Wicked Bitch of the West. Got him. Jesus Christ. All right, moving forward. Is there anything here? I know we're in the middle of a perilous thunderstorm, but, well, you know, it's I like to look at the scenery. That is a very big tornado. Lady, whatever your name is, it is probably best not to stay there.
Holy
shit. Yeah, that is kind of big. Jesus Christ!
Was so surreal. They called film Little
Pieces of Time. Well then, but I guess that was a dream.
Photography, as he likely was.
Okay.
Sorry, give me a second. The spider is looking at me kind of strange. I kind of want to kill it, but at the same time, like, I'm scared. Should I kill the spider? Befriend spider? He's like coming strangely close to me. I don't like it. I know, whatever.
I'm in class. Everything's cool. I am okay.
From light to shadow. From color to chiaroscuro. Now,
hey!
Can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white?
I didn't fall asleep, and that sure didn't feel like a dream. Bueller? Weird.
A phone!
There you go.
Oh, that's
Victoria.
A picture.
Why
look.
Arvis?
Because there are images of hopeless faces.
What?
You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
She saw humanity as tortured,
what?
Right?
What is happening?
And frankly, it's bullshit.
What?
Keep that to yourself.
How do I look?
Seriously, though. I could frame any one of you in a dark corner.
I literally cannot move my, mouse out of this.
Look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson? I can hear the class laughing at me now.
Hey, you like Polaroids? That's pretty cool.
Isn't that too easy? Too obvious? What if Arbus chose to capture people at the height?
Oh, I get it. Oh, you gotta like, okay, that's kind of cool, actually. She could. Let's look at that.
I haven't kept up with my journal as much as I should.
Hey, you have a journal too? I love journals. No, we're not gonna read that just yet.
Robert Frank.
Let's look at the pencil case.
I can't believe I still have this pencil case. I should upgrade to the 21st century.
What the fuck is a 21st century pencil case supposed to look like?
But a beauty in the struggle.
It's like a $2,000 Apple case.
Which explains why Frank was Kerouac's photographic.
Let's look at that.
I do love my analog camera.
Hey!
I should take a picture to prove I'm still here. Plus, it's perfect for my portfolio.
Aim the camera, hold the left button. Okay. Nice.
Capturing the romantic urban solitude of the 20th century poet.
You're supposed to be paying attention to class, lady.
I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift.
Oh,
of course, as you all
I guess
know,
her name is Max.
The portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression.
Hey, selfies are pretty cool.
I couldn't resist. The point remains
pretty
that
good
the
selfie.
Portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits.
Asking me? Let me think.
You either know Albert this or not, Max.
Okay, calm
Is
down,
there
teacher.
Anybody here who knows their stuff?
Albert Einstein.
He's a French painter who created daguerreotypes. A process.
Oh my god, you fucking nerd. I don't
care. Like now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Fucking loser.
Very good, Victoria.
Okay, Victoria. You're a bitch, okay?
Detailing people's faces,
that's why no one likes
making
you.
Them extremely popular from the 1800s onward.
All right, we're reading.
If anybody else looked at this, what would they think?
Page 8 of 8. I'm gonna read through her diary. It's like a creepy thing that we're doing. July 10, 2013. Oh, wow. It's like nearly 10 years ago at this point. I got accepted into Blackwell Academy. Wow. Is that a clearly not exactly a nice academy, considering the other alumni in there? I'm looking at you, Victoria, you bitch. If words could dance, this would be a rave, even though I've never been to one. But who cares? Because I got into Blackwell Academy. I didn't think I would be so excited since it's not like I didn't used to live in the same town, but when I saw the text from the Blackwell Scholarship office, I could literally feel my pulse speed up. I thought it was going to say, sorry, you suck. I mean, thanks for playing. It took me a few seconds before I read the whole thing. I guess I want to enjoy that last moment of blissful ignorance. When I saw the first word, congratulations, I think I screamed. My mom cried, and my dad laughed. They're so weird. Very weird that they would be happy that I got into this school. You know what, Max? Maybe you do have weird parents. I don't know yet. We haven't met them. But they're happy in this, and this means extra financial support because they don't have to pay anything to Blackwell. What? Was there any mention of a scholarship in here? Oh, okay, the scholarship office. Okay. I was gonna say, like, you just got accepted into the school, right? Like, you know, you still gotta pay for it. But I guess she did get a scholarship. Hey, you know what? Pretty cool. This means new clothes and if I can work it, a new laptop. Ooh, maybe a Dell XPS. Something, 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 something. Or maybe an Apple MacBook. That's what all the cool kids have nowadays. And I have to keep telling myself in caps, I'm going to Blackwell Academy. Pretty cool. You know, I was gonna say, maybe we shouldn't read this. due to the time constraint. But I want to get to know Max. We need to get a little bit of an introduction to Max, just so we can know what's going on, I guess, right? August 18, 2013. So this is it. I'm leaving Seattle to go back to Arcadia Bay. Usually people go to the high school closest to home. I suppose I am too. It's just I haven't lived there for 5 years. Out of all the best photography programs in the world, I choose to go to the smallest back in a town I was excited about leaving. Maybe I wanted to come back all along, just to see if Chloe and I are still even friends. But I do wish Chloe could have moved with us to Seattle. That city was made for her. When we would play pirates in our rooms and in the woods, it seemed like Seattle was that fabled faraway island of treasure and adventure that we were always seeking, with coffee shops. I love Seattle. Nice. But Seattle wasn't like a fable. Au contraire, okay? Now Blackwell Academy seems more exotic to me than any other place in the world. To study photography under Mark Jefferson. Sigh. Insert hearts and flowers. Ah, I see. It's like an Edward V. Jacob kind of a situation here. Understandable. Something straight out of Twilight. Mr. Sexy Teacher Man. Plus, there would be cool, diverse students from everywhere. It won't be like my high school now. I never really found a groove with my classmates. Or boys. I'm lucky I have a couple great friends here. But it's time to ship out. So maybe Arcadia Bay will actually turn out to be the island of treasure and adventure I've been looking for. Wait, when was this? To 25, okay. It's not too long, like a week. Shit is crazy here. I didn't realize how much crap I had to pack until I had to pack all my crap. Mom and Dad are getting a little too excited. I'm clearing out my room. Though I caught Mom crying when she was packing my shirts. That made me want to cry like a little girl and never leave Seattle. So instead of packing, I feel like burning all my clothes, then just raiding a thrift store to build up a new Max wardrobe over my junior year. Not that I even have an old Max wardrobe. Nobody will know me except for Chloe, and who knows how different we are now. So I can cut my hair, get a tat and some piercings, maybe date a cute foreign exchange artist from Paris or Rome. I can do anything, unless I get busted. And there will be so many super cool chances for my photography to get exposed. Thinking about that is when I get scared, but excited. And then I don't feel like crying at all. I get tingles down my arm, sensing the universe opening up for me. I can't wait to leave. I just want things to be different. Different at Blackwell. Well, I'm telling you now, Max? Probably not. maybe it will be. Maybe it is different. And maybe I'm a pessimist. But, you know what? Rooting for a new life, I guess. Right? September 2nd, 2013. 12:07 a.m. My first entry for my new dorm room the night before my first day at Blackwell. Whew! I haven't had any time to write or even take pictures since I got here. My shit is in boxes all over the room, which is small, but mine, and I never want to leave. I can't wait to decorate. I plan a whole wall of photos. I did meet some of my dorm mates, though I suck at remembering names, so I won't bother right now. But I think I can already see who's going to be cool with me and who's not. It's a bitch trying to get settled into a new school and social scene after I finally found good friends in Seattle. But I'm here now, and this is the start of my new life. Sweet dreams. And then, a day later... Blackwell sucks ass. Oh, well. that was fast. I told myself not to whine so soon, but damn. The day I started, like Christmas morning, I barely had any dreams because I was so pumped to start my first official day of a new life. Like a dork, I couldn't figure out what to wear, so I chose what was on the floor. I'm no good with names and faces right away, but I picked up some names like Kate Brooke Taylor Alyssa. No, that's an interesting name. It's like four middle names in one. And how could I forget Victoria Chase? Ah, the bitch next to me. Rich, stylish, entitled. I could feel instant judgment when she looked at my raggedy-ass clothes. As if I'm as if I'm at Blackwall to strike fashion poses. Maybe I'm being extra crispy sensitive, but I think Victoria wants life here to be like her own reality show. Yeah, Victoria's a bitch. We already knew that. So that wasn't fun along with my general social unease. I thought it would be easier being back. Call the wambulance! I don't want this day to end all, woe is Max. It was incredible to walk across the green campus in the morning mist. I love the stone steps and the brick walls of Blackwell. Everything is a picture waiting to be taken. Speaking of, at least one great thing did happen today. Mr. Jefferson's photography class. Heart. There's more to tell, but journal, forgive me. I'm truly wiped out. And then September 4th. We're almost done. We're on page 5 of 8. September 4th. I have an ass load of homework already. So much bullshit. At least give us noobs a day to acclimate. Wow, I haven't heard that term noob in a very long time. That is a wildly outdated term at this point. But to prove I'm not a total loser, I made a new friend in my science class. His name is Warren Graham, and he's a serious geek, plus he's dark and witty. He comes across as a kind of a know-it-all, but it turns out he does kind of know a lot. We talk about the stock market, I'm just kidding, no, photographers, and he actually named a few I'd never heard of. We traded numbers, and he'll be a good study partner, or a good friend. I'll need at least one based on the click action here. I thought being 18 meant I didn't have to deal with this teenage drama anymore. I thought. At least I get to research famous photographers for some of my homework. Mr. Jefferson assigned us a ton of reading, but this is exactly what I wanted to study. Jefferson is super cool and super chill. He doesn't try to be too hip, just says what he thinks and expects us to as well. I think he's a genius. Oh my god, I want to marry him! Just joking. This one class is worth all the social dysfunction. September 15th. Homework is kicking my ass. I bet the teachers grade harder just to stop you from feeling special. But Victoria Chase and her snob minions still front like they're honor students of Blackwell. The bros here aren't that different. Nathan Prescott is Victoria's male clone, with way more money and attitude, if that's possible. His family is the oldest in Arcadia Bay, and I heard stories about them when I was a kid. The Prescotts give a shitload of bank to Blackwell, so Nathan acts like he literally owns the school. Yesterday during class, he put his feet on the desk, started texting, and the teacher didn't say jack. I'd get suspended, but him and Victoria are a part of the silly elite Vortex Club that puts on popular parties, and so they get their way. It's good to be the king and queen. I don't want to slam everybody. I do like Kate Marsh. She's down the hall in one of my classes. She's so pretty and sweet and friendly. It makes her more beautiful than the bitches here, like Victoria, who think beauty is just your face and outfit. See, I'm already playing their drama games. No more. September 23rd. Finally had a chance to take some actual shots around campus today. A perfect blue sky day. I always forget how great I feel after taking pictures. After I take pictures. When I've been slacking off. Speaking of pictures, Mr. Jefferson told us about the National Everyday Heroes photo contest he wants us all to enter. The winner gets a trip to San Francisco and lots of publicity. San Francisco, huh? Well, that's I feel like that's more of like a punishment than a reward, but you know, what do I know? He wants just one photograph from each student. This is exactly why I want to come to Blackwell, and of course, I'm scared shitless to enter. At least I have a couple weeks before the deadline in October. So I have plenty of time to stress and procrastinate. Sigh! September 30. I don't know whether I love or hate it here. I'm trying to keep up with my science class, of all things. Like I give a shit or even understand it. Good thing I know Warren. Too bad I can't clone him to take my place in class. Mrs. Grant is much cooler than the class. She explains particle physics, so even boneheads like me can kinda understand. I love how she relates society to science and vice versa. I can tell she's committed and passionate about life. Unlike some of us in her class, but I'm trying to engage more, even if it means asking actual questions in class instead of hiding in the back. I'm just glad I'm not the only social misfit here. Now, how much homework are you avoiding? A lot, actually. Thank you for asking, Max. I appreciate it. For reminding me. October 1st. October. My favorite month. The best weather of the year. I love watching the leaves change color, turning into tiny flames. But it's still too damn hot. Thanks, global warming. Hey, this game knows a lot about modern life, and I can't bust out the big coats and sweaters or scary movies yet. Soon. Kate let me borrow The October Country by Ray Bradbury. I haven't read much by him, which caused Warren to almost revoke my geek cred before I held up my copy of Battle Royale. But he nails the autumn atmosphere of small towns. Hey, Battle Royale! Hey, you know, this Life is Strange is getting in before, you know, the craze. The Fortnite Battle Royale craze. Damn! You know what? Wild shit. But he nails the autumn atmosphere of small towns. Last time I wore a Halloween costume was with Chloe. I have pictures in one of my old albums. I should find a real Halloween party to crash so I can experience some social mingling. Is that or a Vortex Club Stroke Fest swimming party? Or is that Backstroke Fest? You so punny, Max. At least I'm trying to climb out of my cocoon. I shouldn't expect my life to completely change after a few weeks of Blackwell Academy. As my parents love telling me on a loop, you'll have all the time in the world. Well, until you die, but, you know, that being said, regardless, yes. Also, sorry, give me a second. I need to do something real quick. Alright, there we go. Alright. Is there a next? Okay, no, next is going back into one. Alright, now we have everything. Just kidding, no we don't. So this is Kate. Who the fuck is that? This is Max, our main character. Mr. Sexy Jefferson Man. And the bitch. Gotcha. Ah, we got texts now. I see, we're going straight in. So who are we banging today? Did we send nudes to dad? Just kidding, no. That's weird. Alright, exit.
American daguerreotype self-portrait was done by Robert Cornelius. You can find out all about him in your textbook.
Or
even online.
My textbook.
And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest.
Hey, there we go.
With the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Damn, that's a fucking rad teacher. That man, well, it's because I like you. I have a crush. Oh my god. All right.
Damn, they have carbon fiber tripods here. The ball head even has a pan lock. God, I'm such a photo nerd.
Bro, carbon fiber fucking tripods are the best, though. Oh my god. They're sturdy, lightweight. I mean, the ball head is a little bit more common nowadays. I mean, I guess no, they're not. Ball heads are still kind of expensive. So you know what? This is a pretty high quality tripod, if I do say so myself. Because the one that I'm using right now, which is a $20 plastic one from Target, is I mean, it's extremely cheap, first of all. So, you know. But it doesn't have the thing. But also, my tripod doesn't exactly have the water meter, the level meter thing as well. So, if this one doesn't have that, then it's cheapo. You know, very bad. Not very niceness. Yeah, a lot of the more expensive tripods are made of, like, carbon fiber and stuff nowadays. It's because it's light. It's light, but also very sturdy.
Another daily fail in front of the world. I love seeing Mr. Jefferson's awesome photos on these magazine covers.
I can't even tell what's happening here. Is this a photo or a painting? Let's read it. Pop Vine. Is grunge dead? Featuring the latest works from Mark Jefferson. 10 reasons to get electronic mail. Why? Because it's relevant. Alright, continuing on. A printer! I haven't seen that in 5 years.
That printer is amazing. I'd love to see how it reproduces my pictures. I could pump out a whole gallery show with that thing. When I don't suck.
Hey!
Someday.
Max, you gotta have confidence in your photography skills, okay? Even if you aren't the best at it, it's all about practicing makes perfecting.
That was amazing when Mr. Jefferson took a class picture the first week.
The composition is kind of off. Trash.
At all,
boo.
It was fairly fucking cool to watch him at work framing.
Trash. Mr. Jefferson needs to take his own photo class because he sucks. Just kidding, no.
So cool to see Mr. Jefferson's actual published pictures. Gives me hope.
Film versus digital, who will win? Well, you see, I have the benefit of hindsight, and I can tell you now that digital is pretty much 9 out of 10. Alright, let's look.
Of course, Victoria has to have the bestest, newest, most expensive everything.
Hmm, is Victoria in this class? Oh, she is! Alright. Should we look through it? Is that a... I kind of don't want to look through it because you got to be respectful of people's stuff.
Even her school books are gift wrapped. I can't believe she made fun of me in class. What is she, 15 years old? And people laughed. I should have known. She'll have better equipment than Blackwell.
Damn! GRLT-64s. With all the speed and the power expected from a new greenlit, the GRLT-64s is packed with expanded features and manageability. It shoots what you want, where you want. Straight out of the camera, JPEG images already have a superb quality, including a new level of depth, sharpness, and malleability. Ugh. 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 They're shooting JPEGs? Ugh. Trash. Absolute trash. You know what? You might as well buy that. Absolute dog shit. How dare you even... God. Gross. Shooting JPEGs for $5,000? You got me fucking tripping. And not even raw? Bro, come on. Victoria's gonna be taking pictures of, like, poo-poo, bad stuff. What kind of place is this? Thank you for the raid, Dad. I appreciate it, man. Alright, who's this?
Kate looks so sad and quiet today.
Oh, Kate.
Poor thing.
Kate.
Hi, Kate.
Oh. Hi, Max.
Hi. You saying you seem quiet today seems kind of rude, right?
Kate, I hope I didn't embarrass you with my lame answer.
It sucks to be dragged into the spotlight.
I agree.
Victoria.
Well, she's got nothing on you, Max. Well, I should get going.
Victoria's kind of a
yeah,
bitch.
Me too. Talk to you later.
Sure.
Ooh, what's in this computer? Is it porn?
Obviously, Blackwell spent bank on the computers here.
What kind of computer is this? Looks like a... kind of a shitty monitor. Looks like a... it's in a 4:3 ratio. Doesn't look like a 16:9. Alright, no. That looks kind of like a Dell Inspiron. Maybe like a... like an 8300X. Trash! Absolute dog. You can't even play Valorant on this. Can you play Valorant on this? Can I see? I don't think I see enough. Wait, actually, wait. We can use it.
Looks like somebody was already working on this. Cool.
Hmm. Well, it can run Photoshop, but I don't think it could run Valorant. Or League of Legends. Trash! Man, you know, this school sucks. Etched markings. Did someone just write, like... the fuck? What does that say?
This might make a cool shot.
Who? Rachel and Amber forever. Well, that's about to last a week. I mean, the marking will be there forever, but the friendship will last around 5 days. And then it'll just be gone forever. Ooh, photo equipment.
This is definitely where cameras go to heaven.
Are you sure, heaven? Because it's just in a fucking cupboard.
Sweet ultrasonic lenses. And look at that vintage rangefinder.
Vintage rangefinder? What kind of trash? Bro, we got the modern-day mirrorless cameras, okay, Max? I don't want to hear your vintage viewfinder shit, okay? Glass viewfinders are better than mirror ones, okay? Than electronic viewfinders. You can't tell me otherwise. I know none of this probably makes any sense to any of you, but, whatever. Fuck it. Hello, Mr. Jefferson. Would you like to go on a date?
Ridiculous. I always get so shy and nervous around Mr. Jefferson. Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes. Yeah, Victoria.
Excuse you.
No, Victoria. Excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Oh!
Do I have to?
Do I have to? I just don't think it's that big a deal.
Max, you're a better photographer than a liar. Now, I know it's a drag to hear some old dude lecture you, but life won't wait for you to play catch-up. You're young, the world is yours, blah, 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 right? But you do have a gift. You have the fever to take images, to frame the world only the way you envision it. Now, all you need is the courage to share your gift with others. And that's what separates the artist from the amateur.
I mean, technically, yeah, but at the same time, like, I mean, I guess. Wow, you know, I feel like people that do art, me included, because I do photography, they make it a little bit more convoluted than it needs to be sometimes. You know what I mean? Like, this really make it what's set. Wait, you know, we already talked to him. Let's look at Victoria.
Every time I look at Victoria, I feel like she's talking smack about me.
That's because she probably is, Max. She's a bee. All right, let's see what's over here. A lighthouse.
You can never escape the lighthouse here.
Well, that's fucking ominous as hell. Thank you for that insight. Ooh, a camera.
Whoa, Mr. Jefferson is not messing around with that monster.
Yeah, I feel
he
like...
He probably paid 20 grand for that camera. I bet he gets pristine digital images.
I bet it.
But I still dig my little instant camera.
I bet it takes pictures of JPEGs. Fucking trash. Your camera is trash, Mr. Jefferson. Did I ever tell you that? Absolute dog.
Even in pictures, the forest around here always looks mysterious.
Okay, should I continue just being around in this room? I feel like there's just nothing else here. I mean, we've got a TV, I guess, but I feel like, you know, in terms of the things that we've gone through everything. All right, let's leave. Open.
You didn't tell me how cute I looked yet.
I was about to.
I'm not paying $100.
You
welcome
always
to the real world.
Cute.
Hot.
Then I might send you a special picture.
Oh, a special picture, I see. Ooh, you know what? Maybe that's all I need to do.
I need a serious timeout in the bathroom. Splash water on my face and make sure I don't look like a total loser.
Hey, you don't look like a loser. Come on.
It's so fucking boring.
Losers are pretty cool. Which is kind of... No. Drown out the world, Max.
Alyssa is always texting, but she doesn't hang out with a lot of people.
Yeah, sounds like me.
I hate having everybody to see inside my locker. American girls, I love that picture of mom and dad. Hello, Jack. Kiss, kiss. Andy, you
who the hell is Jack?
American girls, I'd like to.
Alright, here's Justin.
That's Dana talking to... I think his name is Justin. Dana is on my floor, too. She's such an archetypal, gorgeous cheerleader.
They're bullying this guy. Oh, God.
I shouldn't be... I hate...
Oh, shit. My bad.
Logan. Andy's a Vortex Club member.
Hey, Vortex Club members are pretty cool.
Poor Daniel, he's so nice. I wish I could beat the shit out of Logan.
Yeah, fucking Logan. I bet his last name is Paul, too. God.
I've seen Brooke hanging out with Warren. She seems like his type.
Alright. Wait, what is she playing? She's on her phone! Alright. Nice. A missing persons poster. Oh, God.
It looks like she's been gone for months.
Missing from Arcadia Bay, April 22nd, 2013, 19, Rachel Amber. Oh, God. Well, I hope we find her. I feel like we're going to find her soon.
I wish October would last forever.
For sale.
Don't need a PC. Missed the Poetry Jam tryouts, and I did not steal that backpack.
All right.
That's so messed up. I should contact him to find out what I can do.
Ah, climate change.
As if I am.
I love climate change. No, I don't. Wait.
I wonder what actually happened to her.
Ah. Alright. Where are you? Trevor?
He's cute. I like skater boys.
Hey!
Too bad they don't like me.
Skater boys are pretty epic. Alright. What's this guy up to? What's up, Hayden?
There's Hayden, another Vortex Club bro. But he's actually not an ass.
Well, who are these two? Zachary and Juliet. That sounds like the most stereotypical names ever. Oh my god.
There's Juliet from my dorm. Yet another Vortex Club disciple.
That actually sounds about right, yeah.
Figures Juliet would be dating Zachary. Jocks sucked up in the Vortex Club.
Was it the names etched on the desk? Wait, was it? Wait, hold up. Wait, can I go back? Wait. Is there a way I can open up the photo? Wait. Okay. See if we have any photos in here. Rachel and Amber? Rachel Amber forever. Oh, wait. Wait a minute. That's her name, right?
I wonder what actually happened to her.
Rachel. Oh. Huh. Well, that makes it 10 times more scary. Jesus Christ. Alright. We're supposed to be moving to the bathroom, right? Alright. Maybe we'll find Rachel Amber one of these days. Alright. The bathroom. Make sure it's the women's and not the men's. Okay. Well, at least I think we're a woman. I mean, it could be, like, vastly different.
Good. Nobody can see my meltdown. Except for me.
That's a bit depressing. Come on, Max. You gotta have confidence. Self-confidence. A mirror. How the fuck do you use a mirror? You just kind of stare through it, right?
I feel like the universe is taunting me everywhere I go today. It all started with that bizarro dream in class. Am I going crazy?
Yes, indeed, actually. I wouldn't put your hands on the sink like that. That's
just
what we call
back.
Unsanitary.
Stop torturing yourself. You have a gift. Fuck it.
Hey, you can't toss your dreams like that. What the fuck?
When a door closes, a window opens. Or something like that.
I hate Victoria Chase. Yeah, that sounds about right. Nobody likes her.
Okay, girl, you don't get a photo op like this every day.
Shh. You're gonna play it slow. What the? What? There's a man in there. This is the woman's bathroom. Well, unless you're...
Don't stress. You're okay, bro. Just count to three.
Uh-oh.
Don't be scared. You own this school. If I wanted, I could blow it up. You're the boss.
Uh-oh.
So what do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Wrong. You got hella cash.
That's my family, not me.
Oh, boo-hoo, poor little rich kid. I know you've been pumping drugs and shit to kids around here. I bet your respectable family would help me out if I went to them. Man, I can see the headlines now.
Leave them out of this, bitch.
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself.
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down.
Don't ever tell me what to do.
Oh God.
I'm so
oh God.
Sick of people trying to control me.
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho.
No.
Well, she did.
Whoa. What the fuck?
Oh!
How can that be?
What the hell?
I was in the bathroom. He shot that poor girl.
Oh!
I held my hand.
And then I was back here.
These pieces.
I already heard this lecture.
From light to shadow. From color.
Now Kate is being hassled again.
Uh-oh.
And if Victoria's phone rings, this is real.
Now, shit. Can you give me an example of a photographer?
I cannot believe this.
Well, restart the world again.
Okay, if I'm crazy, anybody? I might as well go all the way. Bueller? Can I actually reverse time?
There you go, Victoria. Why Arvid?
Holy shit, we're going back to the future? We don't need a car for this. We got our hands.
I actually did it.
A photographer who perfectly captured
a human,
the human
time machine.
Black and white.
Yeah, I feel like you'd be a little.
Max, don't freak out. Not yet.
There you go,
okay, okay, okay. Who?
Because of her. Keep it together, Max.
You
okay.
Feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those.
Still the same. When I took my selfie, Jefferson asked me a question. Tortured, right? If he does again, I'll know this is for real.
Keep that to yourself. Seriously, though, I could frame any one of you in a dark corner.
All right, we're gonna take the selfie.
And capture you in a moment of desperation.
This is what we did before.
And any one of you could do that to me. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift.
Hey, the gift of
I
selfie.
I'm not dreaming this. You all know, it's real. Has been I can tell.
Your generation.
So I can go back in time.
I like how she's so nonchalant about it.
What if that girl isn't dead yet? I couldn't resist.
The point can I save her? The portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography.
I need to go to the bathroom quickly and check it out.
Now, Max, since you've captured.
Okay, well, we've already gone through that. I have to use the bathroom.
I'm sorry, but I really have to use the bathroom.
Nice try, Max. But you're not going to get away that easy. We can talk more after class.
Oh, wait, if I said something different, does it?
Jefferson wants to keep me after class. And I need time to save that girl.
Oh, God. I said something different.
Ooh. Like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Can't believe you actually said sad face, you loser.
What if I rewind again and give him the right answer?
All right, we're going to rewind. We can't stay after class.
Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
All right, all right. There we go.
The Daguerrean process, invented by a French painter named Louis Daguerre around 1830.
Somebody has been reading as well as posing.
Hey, nice work, get shit on, Victoria. You loser, sad face.
Hugely popular, mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features.
Fucking chin.
You can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters. Max is so far way ahead.
All right, we need to leave. Shit.
Hey guys, don't forget speed the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
All right, all right, all right.
Max, you are not crazy. You are not dreaming. It's time to be an everyday hero.
Everyday hero. Yes, all right. Victoria, speed run, baby. Speed run.
Max Caulfield, don't even think about leaving here until we talk about your entry.
Oh, God.
I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
I'm not avoiding, just...
biding time? Waiting for the elusive right moment?
Exactly.
Max, don't wait too long. John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans. Go on now. Don't let me stop you.
All right. What? Wait, what? Wait, why do we need to reverse that?
Yes.
Okay.
Excuse me.
Okay, we need to. Okay, we
talk
to.
You for a moment?
Yes.
Yeah, we.
Excuse
we
me.
Talk to
no,
them.
Victoria, excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
And then we, John Lennon.
I'm on top of it. I think John Lennon once said that life is what happens while
what the fuck does that even have to do with anything?
Max, you're on fire today.
What does that have to do with anything?
All the right answers, good. Make sure you finish working on it by today. I have faith in you.
Alright, nice. Now we're leaving. See you later, Victoria. You loser.
I hope I have enough time to get to the bathroom. Please, please. I can't tell anybody. They'll think I'm crazy.
Whee! Speed run! Oh, well, I guess... Oh, he dead.
You know I don't tease.
I hate that song.
All right.
Okay, Max. Retrace every step. I washed my face. I shredded my photo. Then the butterfly flew in. And I took a photo.
Use the bucket! Kill the guy!
Leave them out of this bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am!
Alright!
You're messing around with!
Where'd you get that?
Oh!
What are you doing?
Oh!
Come on, put that thing down!
Tell me what to do!
Wowzer, so I need a hammer to break it open!
To control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs!
Nobody would ever even miss
you! Okay, well take it! Take the hammer!
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Holy shit, I can't let this happen.
Okay.
If I can reverse time again, I can help her.
Nobody would ever even
Max,
miss your
you're going to get hurt.
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Okay, nope. Okay.
Don't ever tell
okay,
me
okay, we need to move that.
I'm so sick of people trying to control...
Wait.
I'm so...
Wait. We need to go all the way back.
Don't
we speed run this.
Tell me what to do. I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get
oh God,
hell
wait.
More trouble for this than drugs.
Oh, we already have the hammer, okay.
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
Oh God.
Another shitty day.
Oh God.
That did not happen. This cannot be
yeah,
real.
I thought it would reverse my me having the hammer.
Shot and then saved her. What the fuck
I thought it would reverse.
On?
Never mind. Okay,
did
so you can keep the item.
Out.
Gotcha. Now we know.
Hey, do you hear that fire alarm? That means you should be outside.
Bro, I literally just it's like 5 seconds.
Girls always use that excuse.
Excuse for what?
For whatever you're up to. Your face is covered in guilt.
The alarm tripped me out.
Then trip on out of here, Missy. Or are you hiding something? Huh?
Oh, I, do you want to tell me?
The situation is under control.
Jesus
no
Christ.
Emergency here. Leave Miss Caulfield alone and please turn off that alarm.
Yeah.
Since that's your job.
Yeah, you loser. Fuck out of here, bitch. Thank you, Mr. Principal Man, I think. Maybe. It's like a 10% chance you're actually the principal. Actually, no, he looks like a principal, right? Hello, Mr. Principal Man. Ah, Principal Wells. What do you look like?
Principal Wells always looks so distracted. I can never figure out what he's thinking.
He's thinking about why the school
is
underfunded.
Me?
You look a little stressed out. Are you okay?
Absolutely not.
I'm just a little worried about my future.
You're sweating pinballs. Is that all you're thinking about? You can always be upfront with me, Max. Or have you done something wrong? Is that it? Well, Max, talk to me.
Report Nathan. Yeah, we can always reverse.
I just saw Nathan Prescott waving a gun around in the girls' room.
Nathan Prescott. You sure?
Yes, he was in the bathroom talking to himself with a gun. I saw everything. He was babbling like crazy.
Okay, slow down. Slow down. So now you saw this without him seeing you.
I was hiding behind a stall. I have the right to be there. It's the girls' room.
I know. I just want to be completely clear what happened. Mr. Prescott happens to be from the town's most distinguished
family, rich boy.
And one of Blackwell's most honored students. So it's hard for me to see him brandishing a weapon in the girls' bathroom. So what happened next?
Then he left. I ran out here wondering what to do. Are you gonna bust him?
This is a serious charge. I'll look into the matter
first. Yeah.
Thank you for bringing it to my attention.
They always say that. Is anything ever going to happen?
What I told you.
We'll continue this discussion later in my office. Please go outside with the rest of your class now, Miss Caulfield.
All right.
Of course this academic drone won't do anything since the Prescott family owns Blackwell now. Should I rewind and change my story?
I don't know. Oh god. That's a good point, because like if the fucking rich asshole finds out that I told them, then he's going to not be very happy, and then he's going to get somebody else in trouble, because they have rich people and they have all the money. But if we change the story, then he's never going to...
Max, you better go on outside.
He's never going to, like, do anything. Alright. We're leaving it as it is. If somebody dies, oh well. We're a good student. We're not going to be an asshole. Also, isn't there a fire alarm drill? Why is everyone just here? You're supposed to be in the back in the line, everybody. Come on. It's a fucking fire alarm, not picnic day.
Would Nathan Prescott please come to the front office? Thank you.
Ooh, Nathan Prescott, looks like you're in trouble, Mr. Man. Alright, mountain. Sit. Now please don't fall in.
This day has been so insane. Everything is happening too fast.
Hey, Obi-Wan Kenobi!
None of it makes any sense. These visions, this power. I keep expecting to wake up one more time. But if this is a dream, then I'm not asleep.
Oh, gee.
Which means somehow I did rewind time. So there has to be a reason, and I have to find out why.
Hey, I hear a music. Or a radio. Nathan Prescott gets shot. Rushing to the principal gets shot. Nathan Prescott comes out like, I'm the principal now, bitch. Like, Jesus Christ. Okay, fucking, goddamn, calm down. So what's happening? Is this just sitting down time? Oh, I can stand. Okay. I was sitting there like, actually, you know what? I'm gonna sit down for a minute. I'm gonna go take a tinkle. Sorry, be right back. You guys can enjoy this little
this day
thing there.
Has been so insane.
All right, we're back. Hello? All right, no more fountain. Can my dad be okay? Well, you guys are reward. That's not the rewarded. That's a different word. It's rewarded with a T instead of a W.
I better read Warren's text.
Wow.
Before he blows my phone.
Man, kids at the school are kind of mean. Ooh, wait. Messages? What the fuck? What is happening? Hello? What? You are typing very fast. I can't even read any of this. Do you want to meet me after school? I need an excuse not to study. Please. Okay, I guess we're just ghosting him. We've been ghosting him for like an hour and a half. Make sure you check out Net Romantic on my flash drive. Mwahaha. Hey Max, let's bust shit up. Wait, I have to study for a physics test, so if we bust anything, we also have to measure its velocity. Don't ignore this message, can I get my flash drive in space, hello? So he's been getting ghosted for like 5 days now. Heh, get wrecked. Sorry, running late, insane day. I'll meet you in a lot, looking cool, you'll see. My camera will be ready, see you shortly, I hope so. Alright, nice.
Okay, I better get to my dorm and grab that flash drive.
Flash drive, where? Stella, who are you? You guys seem fun.
Stella always looks so serious and dedicated. Good for her.
Alright.
Hey there, Stella.
Hello!
Hey, I know you.
You're the new quiet girl in Jefferson's class. Isn't he incredible?
I think so.
I think so. We're lucky to have such a famous teacher. And I actually love his work.
Me too. His New York urban stuff is great, but I'm glad he came back to his Oregon roots.
So Oregon Trail!
It must piss off those pretentious galleries that Mark Jefferson is teaching photography to us Blackwell Hicks. Plus, he is pretty hot for an older guy. If Victoria wasn't all over him, I would definitely make a move.
Victoria?
Victoria is pretty obvious. I don't think Jefferson is into her.
Yeah.
I don't think she's
Victoria's
close to
a meal, bitch.
But she's not the only player.
Oh, is every girl trying to go for this dude or something? Goddamn.
You have a lot to learn here.
Shit.
Well, Rachel Amber absolutely had sex with him. Well, I heard that from a good source.
Well, that has to be some sort of illegal, right? Because she was... Oh, no, she was 19 when the missing posters happened. I mean, I guess not illegal, per se, but still weird.
So, you knew Rachel?
Not really. I saw her hanging with the other cool kids like Victoria. Not my kind of clique. But I heard insane stories about Rachel.
All right. Interesting. Thank you for that bit of information, Stella. I appreciate it. I would definitely, yes. Oh, no, where the fuck do we go? How do we leave? Where's the dorm? Where is the dormitory? There's Brooke playing on her iPad, watching Cocomelon instead of PewDiePie, as per usual. There's a lady. Nice. Hello, lady. Hello, other lady. Swimming pool? Ooh! No admittance without faculty supervision. Well, I mean, I guess this is a high school, right? We're not exactly looking at university dormitories or nothing here. Now, where are the dorms? What the hell? I'm so confused. Hello, dormitory! Also, dorms in high school? Really? That's actually a thing? Crazy. My high school never had dorms. Alright. Stick with me? Maybe this way's the dorms. Exhibition panel. Interesting. It's an academy? That's true. Who the fuck are you? Damn! Mr. Man over here. What's up, Evan?
I think his name is Evan. He always looks so intense.
Look at him with a nice haircut.
Evan, mind if I check out your cool portfolio?
No.
Let's see if you're worthy of it, Max.
Okay, what an asshole.
You have to answer a simple question. Who photographed the famous falling soldier?
Gotta be Eugene Smith.
Well, they both were famous war photographer images. But you should...
Alright, definitely not him.
Good try. Wrong answer.
Alright. Alright, now we ask him again.
Hey, Evan.
Alright.
Let's see if you're worthy of him.
Okay. It's not Eugene Smith. Stevie McCurry.
Steve McCurry?
Unless he could travel back in time. McCurry was born 5 years after the falling soldier picture. McCurry also shoots in color. In other words, no portfolio.
What an asshole. Trying to answer a fucking quiz. I know I don't need to do this, but like, I kind of want to, okay?
Hey, Evan.
Let's see.
Okay. Robert. Two Roberts. Dusneu.
Isn't it Robert Dorneau?
Oh my. You can't even tell the difference between street photography and photojournalism.
God damn it.
Portfolio peak for you.
Oh my god, what a pussy. I hate this guy. I actually hate this guy. You know what? I want to see your portfolio,
hey,
so I can just blow it up.
Mind if
I toss it in the trash can and light it on fire.
Let's see if you're worthy of it, Max.
God, what a fucking snob. Okay, I don't care. Alright, Robert Capa.
Robert Capa, of course. I love his work, despite the controversy.
I picked every wrong answer, Christ.
My. This quiet child knows things.
That's why I'm here.
You're a kindred spirit, Max. Would you care for a perusal of my portfolio? It's not a privilege I grant to many.
I'd be honored, sir.
This guy's such an asshole. Oh my god. What a pompous dick. I hate
These
you.
These photos are great. And Rachel Amber's face is mesmerizing.
I hate you. I hate you, Mr. Evan Man. You suck. I had to answer all that, just look through three photos? You schmuck.
Hi, Evan.
As you can see, Rachel Amber was my favorite model here. She knew exactly what angles were...
I'm rolling my fucking eyes. What was she like?
What was she like?
She was like Mercurial.
You're a bitch.
You know what that means.
What the fuck does that... What? What does that mean?
She was like a... What do you think happened to her?
Nothing good, Max. Nothing good.
Well, at least we know a little bit more. Oh, God. You're a fucking dick, Evan. I hate you. You suck. Yeah, this middle figure right here, that's for you. I hate you, Evan. What a snobby asshole. What are you doing over here? Playing Yu-Gi-Oh? In a photography school? Go to Master Duel if you want to do it. Ooh, graffiti! Vortex Club sucks. Well, that's about right. Alright, Luke, what's up? Hello, Luke. Who are you?
That's Luke Parker. Zachary pushed him into a locker last week. Go bullies.
Ooh, bullying! We need more of that in our school. No, no, I can't say that.
Max, I don't feel like talking.
What a fucking asshole.
Oh, sorry. I won't bother you.
What a dick. You know what? You deserve to get bullied. Okay. Okay. Alright. 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 Also, hello, Blue. Yeah, Dave already said it. I read your messages. I just gotta do the stuff. Alright. Looking. I said looking, not entering. Hello?
Come on, Logan, bring it, brah.
Brah? Does every bully wear a Letterman jacket or something? Is that just like a hallmark sign of being an asshole? Jesus Christ. Every football player and their mom has to wear a Letterman jacket, I guess. It's part of the school tradition. It was like a cultural tradition, I guess, in that case, right?
Yeah.
Alyssa, weren't you just back there a minute ago? What? You fucking teleporting bastard. Alright. What's up, Alyssa?
I feel like Alyssa and I should be better friends.
Well, you gotta talk to her.
Oh.
This is how we start.
Max.
Hello.
What are you reading?
Love today or die forever. Don't even say it.
Ah!
It's a
the modern adaptation to Twilight.
Good point. Now if you'll excuse me.
Okay, that... ended very abruptly. I guess she doesn't want to be friends. Wow, fine. Oh my god, it's the bitch. You know what? Let's make some let's make some enemies. You know, I like making some enemies.
Oh look, it's Max Caulfield, the selfie hoe of Blackwell. What a lame gimmick.
Oh.
Even Mark, Mr. Jefferson, falls for your waif hipster bullshit.
Hey, at least he falls for me and not for you, fucking loser.
Ligarian process, sir. You could barely even say that. I guess you got your meds filled.
Oh, what a bitch. No wonder why your name is Victoria.
Since you know all the answers, I guess you have to find another way into the dorm. We ain't moving. Oh, wait. Hold that pose.
Ah, the cell phone.
So original. Don't worry, Max. I'll put a vintage filter on it right before I post it all over social medias. Now, why don't you go fuck your selfie?
Oh, yes, Victoria. I'll get your bony ass out of my way.
You did not just say that. You think you'll pass.
Capiche?
You did not just say, go fuck your selfies. Oh my god. Victoria, you suck. You have the worst joke in all of existence. Go back and get the hammer. Do you have to have the hammer? Check your bag, Max. Check your bag. We're going to clobber her over the head, and if the repercussions are too bad, we'll reverse it back. Sir, please don't fall. You look like you're not very... I'm scared. Sir... Sir. Uh-oh. Oh! A paint bucket! I don't know what that does, but, say again? Wait a minute. Can we climb up the side over here? Ah, parkour! Ah, never mind. Can we knock the guy off his ladder like an asshole? Oh god. Look. That is a sprinkler.
Bring the sprinkler up and give Victoria and her clones incentive to beat it.
Hmm. Wait, what? It says Samuel. How can I do something about that? Excuse? We need to teach this bitch a lesson for using the term selfie.
Think, Max. Rewind and find something.
What? Oh, the paint bucket! The paint bucket! Okay.
Do you understand English? Get lost.
What?
Awesome.
Wait, hold up. How far can we bring this thing back? Oh, the paint bucket. We tamper with that. Somehow. How the fuck are we supposed to do that?
No. Okay, let's see if this works.
What did we just do? I have a weird feeling we didn't really do anything. We just kind of like... I guess. Sure. Hi, Mr. Man! Took a fucking year and a half to climb up that ladder again. Okay, now how do we tamper? Alright.
Awesome. Ho! Ho!
Now we sit here and wait. Do we drop like a grenade in there or something?
Close, but no cigar. They have to be right under the bucket.
Ah! I see! Okay. Okay, so we need to tamper with the bucket. And then we need to talk to them somehow.
Okay, let's see if this works.
And then we talk to them.
Sorry, no paparazzi allowed.
Victoria is not getting the hint.
Oh, wait. We need the sprinkler somehow. Shit. Where do we get one of those? See you later, Mr. Janitor. Use. Turn that baby into overdrive!
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this.
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Oh, it will be for a minute.
Water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
Oh my god.
Great. I can't even chill on the steps.
Oh. And then he gets the bucket up. Yeah. Hey. See you later, loser. Whee!
Okay, Victoria?
Oh, Samuel is sorry. Wet paint is not good for hair, nope.
Oh, Samuel.
Weirdo.
Oh. I'm sorry,
hold on,
Samuel.
Hold on. We'll get some towels.
I feel
right
bad.
So
I feel bad.
It worked.
Well, I don't feel bad for Victoria.
Max, bitches.
Yeah. Max is cool. Now, can I get a hammer? Wait, hold up. I need a hammer just in case she tries to push a two-timer on me. I see a bunch of pendants right there. Any weapons we could use? Maybe a gun or something? Can you imagine the janitor just pulls out a fucking piece? Hello, sir, what? Samuel doesn't want to take your shit anymore. Hey, Jesus Christ. Samuel, calm down. Fuck. My goodness. Aw, Victoria, what's wrong, huh? What are you, a loser? Boo-hoo.
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
We'll comfort her, because we're a nice person.
I am sorry. That's an awesome cashmere coat.
It was. But there'll be another.
Hey, well, friendship!
You always seem to know how to pick the right outfits.
I do have some talent. Mr. Jefferson told me.
I've seen your pictures. You have a great eye. Richard Avedon-esque.
Aww.
He's one of my heroes. Thanks, Max.
Oh, so nice. Hey, see? You gotta treat it with kindness.
I hope those sluts get me a towel before they hang a sign on me. You deserve a better shot. Sorry about blocking you and...
Yeah.
And the go fuck yourself.
I mean, go fuck your selfie thing. That was just cringe.
But
pretty funny.
That was kind of cringe, not gonna lie.
One of those days.
That was pretty bad.
I know exactly what you mean, Victoria. I'll see you later.
It's the kind of jokes you think about in the shower. And then, like, you're like, it's one of those jokes that, like, you go on Reddit, and then, like, you know, Victoria for, like, good comebacks.
I should have played her. Better get to my room before I find Warren.
Alright, nice. Making friends with enemies to the kid? True. Alright, left mouse. Let's do this. Hello, Sushi. How you doing, man? Oh, the dorms. Are you sure this is a dorm or the fucking Arkham Asylum? This, wow. Actually, Arkham Asylum. Jesus Christ.
Victoria is going to be pissed we took so long.
Pull the fire alarm again.
At least that's an alarm from this century.
I never understood, like, the fire alarms with the glass on it. Like, how the hell you expect to pull that? Shit makes no sense. No boys allowed.
As if.
Well, I guess I'm not allowed here. Alright, see you guys later. Jesus Christ. What does the sign say? Taylor is a slave. We're just not gonna look at that. HIV and AIDS aren't just initials on a poster. Well, I mean, I get, yeah. These are serious life-threatening diseases. Yes, 100% true. On September 16th, my backpack with all my school books and my new tablet was taken from the cafeteria after I left it on the table. There's our invaluable images of my late cat, so I would appreciate the you have my address. Okay. To the bitch that stole my Franzu new face creme. Wow. I know words. That was expensive shit and I need it for my acne. I know exactly how it exfoliates and I will be watching your skin the second it clears up. Wow.
Go, Miss Grant. Not sure if I will, though. I'm a loser.
Intrusive surveillance system. Okay, well, it's just creepy people spying on girls. Well, that's great. Thank you. All right. Well, there is clearly no shortage of creeps in this school. Red drum. What the fuck? What, did it have like a stroke or something? What? What is that even? What? How the fuck did you? What? Excuse me? What is that even? I guess we just look at it.
217? No way in hell am I ever going in here.
Why? Is that where all the nice, cool boys are? Ooh, the frat boys. Stomp 'em, Bigfoot. Well, clearly we're not a Bigfoot. You know, Bigfoot's not really a friendly around these parts. I guess they're more for the Sasquatch or the Chupacabra.
This girl must have been popular. She's everywhere.
You know, Max, I don't think she's everywhere because she's popular. I think she's everywhere because she's missing. You know, like a missing poster. I don't really know that has the much to do with popularity. But I mean, sure, Max. Yeah, we'll go with popular. Yeah, that's what it is. Clearly, you know. Missing is just kind of like a side gig, you know, it's like a side quest. Her main character trait is being popular, though. That's pretty good. Alright. Geek girls. That sounds like me. I wish I was a geek girl. Hello? I mean, I'm not looking inside the bathroom. What? I would never do such a thing. Moving onward, I guess. We'll bang for Jesus. Well, clearly a Christian Catholic. Max's room.
Just get to your room and grab Warren's flashlight.
Shh! I want to see all the cool stuff. 3.14 pi. Okay. Well, that was boring. Oh! I understand why it's pi now. Oh, wait. That took me way too long. Oh, my God. It's pi day because the 4 is the P and then the 1 is the I and then the 3 is the E. That somehow took me far too long. It took me 21 years to figure that out. I understand now. That's why it's called pie. Huh. I mean, I wasn't the only one that knew that, right? Or that didn't know that, right? One of you knew that, didn't know that too, I hope. The forks, okay?
After all this action, I still have to get Warren's file.
I know, calm down. I just wanted to do some stuff. Actually, I want to draw. Warren can wait, Max. Want to what can't? My epic art skills. Hey, peace sign. Yeah. This action will have consequences. Well, I hope they're not bad consequences. Alright, moving in. Alright.
Home sweet home. My favorite cocoon.
Now, where can we find the gun? I've got to teach that one guy a lesson. That jockstrap looking motherfucker. Pull the piece, Max! We've got retribution! What is this? It's like
Warren
a note.
Warren even left me a little message with his flash drive. He's such a goofball.
The fuck does this say? To Max or whom it may concern. Sorry. The cinematic contents of this flash drive are of a graphic, life-altering, controversial nature. This collection has been downloaded with the greatest care and for the most discriminating viewer. I congratulate you on your taste and eagerly await your in-depth reviews of Cannibal Holocaust and Ultra Vixens. Cannibal Holocaust, huh? Well, that seems like a very articulate type of media to be, yes. Anyways, let's get the thingamabob now.
I am so addicted to this site. Look at these vintage beauties.
Camera porn. What? Yeah, I too enjoy looking at camera porn. It's my favorite pastime activity, in fact. Yeah. You know, I love looking at when they, you know, at their mini HDMI ports or their USB mini. Or yeah, USB B mini ports, you know. So when you get the mini HDMI and you plug it into the thing. Yeah. Yeah, those are yeah, you too. Hey. All right, continuing onward,
Warren,
I guess.
Makes me laugh. It's nice to feel like I already made a real friend here.
Max, thanks to your email and copy of Jefferson's class notes, now I shall never stop sending you messages of gratitude. But la 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 la. Okay. Vaughn Tyler. Okay, nice. We have all the art books, all the... Ooh, what's in the drawer? The piece?
Max and Chloe, best friends forever. Who even says that anymore? I'm going to have to call Chloe eventually and find out what she'll say. The longer I wait, the worse it'll be. Idiot.
Baka! That's what they say, right? Alright, cushion. This teddy bear is fucking dead. Now, where's that flash drive? I've been trying to find it for like a year and a half now. Water the plant!
You are thirsty. I'm the worst baby mama. Drink up.
You are thirsty. Wow. This action will have consequences. I hope watering the plant doesn't get Max killed or something. Imagine. Because you watered the plant, now your head. Now you have a hole in your head. The fucking bully comes out with a gun again. It's like, Jesus Christ. Calm down, I just watered my plant. It's like, nope. That's exactly why you're gonna die now, bitch. Jeez. Goddamn. You put a piece on the door? Now we have two guns. My goodness. Now, where is this fucking flash drive? I've been trying to find it for like a year and a half. I'd expected it to be on the computer, but I guess not.
Looks like Dana left me a little post-it note.
I borrowed your drive so I could watch some flicks while I study. If you need it back, just track me down in my room. XOXOD. Well, I hope by flicks you mean definitely non-pirated movies. I hope you didn't pirate any movie there, Max, because that's illegal. And the FBI will be knocking on your door really soon. Also, wow, look at that. Holy shit. Damn, it's got like the actual, like, the mirror reflection and stuff. Oh, that's kind of neat. Look at you, Max. You're cool. You are awesome.
Hard to believe I'm 18. Do I look any older? Just more stressed.
I mean, like, I don't think 18 is that old. I wouldn't consider that, you know, like, I don't think the minute you turn 18, you start getting wrinkles on your face. Look like a politician or something. Say cheese! Hey! Oh, I love Polaroids. I'm a camera nerd myself, if you guys didn't know that, actually. So I'm paying attention to everything that they're saying in here, okay? I know all about my cameras. In fact, I'm using my camera right now to do the... So you guys are the camera, actually. Think about that. Alright, continuing onwards. Wait, we have to look at the thing.
The Max Caulfield Photo Memorial Wall.
That sounds depressing. Alright, anyways, let's continue on. Alright, moving forward. Leave Max's room. We need to find D. Where the fuck that is.
You can't get out now, Dana. So tell me the truth or rot in there.
Ooh, girl drama. Ooh, spicy. Let me hear about it.
Queens of Blackwell.
Hello, Juliet.
What?
Hey, Juliet. Is everything cool?
Oh, yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
Yeah, that sounds like that. What did she do?
What did she do?
What didn't she do? Dana's been sexting with my boyfriend.
How did you find out?
Yeah.
Why do you care? Why are you even
Jesus
asking me?
Christ.
You never talk. Just zone out with your camera.
Okay, well, that's kind of mean.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last name?
Good question. I don't even know my last name. Juliet Patson. Yeah, that sounds like a good that's like a good one.
Juliet Patson.
That was truly sad. Thanks for your concern, Max Caulfield.
Ah, thank you for telling me your name.
Juliet Watson.
Don't worry. I can literally just reverse time, so thank you for that. I wish I had this power, dude, so I can, like, actually remember people's names and shit.
Hey, Juliet.
Okay, shh.
Oh, yes, Max. I've...
Okay. Juliet Watson.
Juliet Watson, you be nice.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do.
Thanks. I locked Dana in because she was sexting Zach, my boyfriend. Unbelievable.
Ah! I see. Spicy! You
know? Victoria Chase. You know her.
Yes.
You could say that. But why would Dana go after your boyfriend?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
Wow, those quarterbacks. Pretty high class.
Huh.
You know what? I would do anything to date a quarterback, too.
And Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Oh.
I swear I didn't do anything, but I bet Victoria did.
Uh-oh, that's not very nice. Now, how do we, how do I, speak?
I'm not letting her out until she tells the truth.
Uh-oh. Maybe we need to go and talk to, Victoria, and then be like, hey, quit being a baby.
No need to go there now.
Never mind. Oh, there goes that. Okay, now how do we break out Dana? There's a small vent in the front there, but I don't think that she can fit through that. I don't think I can fit. Wait a minute, there's a giant vent over here. Alright, we need to stage a breakout. Alright, Max, I think all we need is a couple bricks of C4. We'll put it on the side door over here, or the side wall over here. We'll blow her out, don't worry. Dana, you'll be safe real soon. I just need a pack of detonator. I don't know if you'll survive.
And check out Victoria's room to find out if she is the kind of person I hope she's not.
All right. Time to start looking around. So where's all the porno? What is that?
Well, at least she puts her photographs out there. Unlike me.
Ooh, a rejection letter, my favorite. All right. Ooh, a camera.
She's
DSLR.
Got a classic medium format camera with some awesome prime lens. I hate you, Victoria.
It's probably one of those trash SLR cameras. Not even a digital one. It's got like the fucking roll of film and everything. What a loser. Keck W'd. Trash.
They should call this series aloof. Cold and soulless. Kind of like Victoria.
Hey! She wanted to be nicer to you. You gotta be nice back, Max. Now you seem kind of like the meanie face. Alright.
No, officer. I'm not snooping. Just admiring Victoria's cutting-edge tech.
Alright. Let's see if there's any snoopy snoop snoop on the...
Is she going to get a 3D printer for her... Maybe I will join her posse.
Bro, honestly? I wouldn't even blame you at that point. My god, a 3D printer? That shit's pricey as hell. That's not even cheap. Dear lord.
Okay, if I did wear expensive jewelry, I would wear this for sure.
Bro, you know, I understand. I'm not the kind of person to wear expensive jewelry, but I'm just saying, that's 24 karat gold right there, baby. That ain't cheap.
Yes, I get it. Enter the Vortex Club. No.
But why? It's cool. All right. Time to go snooping to the porno.
I'll give Victoria props for not posting my photo. And for this nice shot. Boom. This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here.
Taylor, so sad to inform you that I totally punked Juliet and Dana just now. All I had to do was mention to Juliet that I saw a nasty text from Dana on Zach's phone. Dumb as, believe me, so I can expect there to be a dorm rampage soon. Juliet deserves this for slutting Zach away from me. As for Dana, who gives a shit? Well, that's not very nice. Please apologize right now. Man, is school actually like this? Is this what university is like? Thank God I don't fucking stay in dorms. Christ. That actually sounds more depressing than anything I've ever seen in my life. I hope school really is not like this. What is that? Like a police radio or something? Like a police scanner.
Victoria hates Rachel Amber this much? How insecure.
Jeez. That's not very nice. Ooh, bring this for $1 off? Hell, whoa. Where's my invitation? All right. Now let's find out where the toy drawer is. Not that I... Never mind. What the fuck? Oh, I didn't see that. Oh, it's a Chad from a fucking... like the memes. Oh, so they were the ones that took the pictures of the Chad. I see. Victoria, the meme maker, I guess. Oh, God. I was half expecting her to open the door and just Victoria be standing right there. You snooping through my shit, you bitch? It's like, goddamn. Oh, I'm just trying to hang out. Don't worry, Dana. We are currently setting up the 4 tons of bomb on this side wall. Right, it will blast you out real soon. We'll also blast you, but, you know, collateral damage. Just kidding, no. All right. Juliet, let me tell you the tea.
Leave me alone, Max. Get a clue.
No, I actually have a clue, literally. No, Juliet, I literally have... Wait.
I'm not letting her out until she tells the truth.
But I have the truth, What the heckies? Am I supposed to, like, install it on a fucking flash drive or something? Like a psychopath? Alright, time to go back. Where's your porn folder? Oh, print email. Oh my god, I haven't seen that be done in, like, 10 years at this rate. Dear lord. printing a fucking email? Jesus Christ.
I bet Victoria put Juliet on her shit list after this
article. Is the Vortex Club a cult? Okay, nice. All right, we'll take that.
This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent.
All right. Now I have the tea. I thought I could just send it to you by text, but I guess, you know, phones don't exist. We gotta do this manually. You know, taking a screenshot just isn't an option in 2013, I think is when this game takes place. You know, the iPhone didn't really exist, except for the phone that you're holding right now. Whatever.
Juliet, read this.
Here, paper.
Of course. I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Dana.
You are. And I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No, but I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max. You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
Wait, now I'm trying to figure out how the hell did she keep almost the door closed?
Get the flash drive and then I'll go see Warren.
The door opens inside, right? Like, it clearly opens inside. And you'd assume that the lock would also be on the inside. So how the hell did she lock her out? What? Physics? Magic. Ah, yes, cast a spell on the door. Ah, pshew! Expelliarmus. The door is just impossible to open. Just a sheer physical manifestation. If I think about it hard enough, I can will it into existence. Alright, this is my flash drive.
Must protect my precious so Max never has to chase it down again.
Okay, Gollum, calm down. Calm down. that's kind of funny. Alright, let's see what porn you have on your computer.
Of course a popular cheerleader like Dana would have a million friends.
Hey, I got a million friends too.
To peek into Dana's social media world.
By a million, I mean 900.
Yes, Max, so terribly wrong.
I mean 900,000 bots and one friend that's not a bot, which is just my secondary account on Facebook. A little bit sad, but whatever. All right, continuing onwards. Wait, we can use the flash drive? Oh, let's see what porno we have installed on this one.
Make sure everything is still in there. I think Warren forgot to hide the Party Buster folder. Not that I would open it, no matter how tempting. I have my self-respect.
Ah, the Party Buster, unholy obscenities. Hmm. Ladies and gentlemen, I think we found the porn folder. Now, how do I click in it? It's a double click, right? It's like Windows 10? Unfortunately, I do not think we can open the porn folder at this current time. But, you know, with that being said. Alright. You didn't look through the porn, right? Did you? I hope not. Oh my gosh, the hot cheerleader! Man, I wish I was a hot cheerleader. But I'm not nearly that cool. Aw. They're cute. I don't mind waiting out here forever. I love this parking lot. I can count all the cars. Okay, you know, I had shit to do. Fucking Warren, don't give me sass, asshole. Alright, here we go. Now we can leave. Open sesame. Alright. The coast seems clear. I don't think we see any bad guys.
Damn, I better rewind.
Damn, just for all the drama. You know, so much for having no drama.
Alyssa, move your head.
If you insist, Max.
Okay, sure, whatever.
I actually helped somebody.
Oh, because the window. Oh, shit. Well, rest in peace, I guess. We'll deal with the consequences, whatever. I speak.
Max, that was awesome. Thank you.
Aw, so cute. No problem.
No problem. You have quick reflexes.
Years of mad dodging skills. Bullies never change.
That's why you're better off.
You're smart. We should hang out more. Now I have to finish this stupid book.
Hey, we made a friend. Alright, now what's this guy I want? Hello, sir. Are you okay, Mr. Zachary Man?
Get lost, hipster. I'm not doing any interviews.
Wait, that's a meme. Alright. Now, whose weird photos are you snooping through this time? Mm. Ooh, a text string. I see. Drama. Lovely. I don't care. The Prescott Dormitory, donated by Sean Prescott. What a fucking snarky asshole. The Athletic Club. Ooh, wait, what are we doing again? We need to go to the parking lot, right? Where the fuck is that? I guess we go around the front of the building. That's where the parking lot is. I hope.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell.
Oh God, what an asshole.
What I'm saying.
No, and leave me alone.
Take a photo. No. We get photo evidence. We don't want to intervene because we could get hurt too, and we have no evidence. Because it's the security man. What a creeper. But it's going to show the flash. It's going to be a weird ew.
You can't fool me. I know everything about this school. I cover the waterfront. So you better figure out what side you're on.
Please, leave me alone.
Okay, apparently they're just fucking deaf. So, well, thank God for that, I guess.
Hope you enjoyed the show. Thanks for nothing, Max.
Hey, you're welcome. I have photo evidence now.
Man, I should have stepped in between Kate and David.
Ah, you know what? We'll
that
see.
That asshole was so we'll over the line.
God, fine. What a dick.
I could rewind and try something different.
You know what? We'll try. We want to be nice to people, okay? All right. Fine. All right. We're going to intervene.
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Hey, dumb bitch.
Excuse us. This is official campus business.
Excuse me. You shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
Yeah, asshole. Okay, you know, that seemed like the right one. Until later, that one will actually have more consequences.
Great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Anytime, Kate.
You know, considering the,
I felt like an everyday hero helping Kate, but now Officer David Dickhead is after me. Maybe I should rewind and...
No, we're gonna roll that one. That one seems more fun. You know, I have a really weird feeling that they're gonna end up using their power to do some really awful shit. I don't want to think about that just yet. No. Well, if it comes up to it, it comes up to it. We'll do our best to kind of like dodge that shit. You know what I mean? You and I, we're gonna be safe. And so is Max. Hello? Is it me you're looking for?
I'm glad I stepped in that time.
Hello, Juliet.
I can't stand to see people being bullied.
What about Romeo?
Did Zach and Victoria do that to me?
Hi, Juliet. How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Max. Sorry, I'm still screwed up.
Aww. Sorry about Zachary.
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way. Or anyway.
Better sooner than later.
That's true. That's true.
Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
Oh, they are using loaded terminology here.
Mr. Badass Football Hero is such a chicken shit. He said he sexted Victoria as a joke.
Ah, a joke. Haha, very funny.
I think Warren wants your attention.
He usually does. Hang in there, Juliet.
See you around, Max.
Warren, I'm trying to make a new friend here. I don't have time for your bitch ass and your porn folder USB. God, you can wait 10 minutes, right? Quit jerking off, you fucking weirdo.
Max, get your ass over here.
Oh my God, you know I'm just gonna leave.
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Oh!
Very old school.
Damn!
1978 to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 6 miles
I'm not sucking
away.
Your dick, Warren.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then...
God!
So am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
I don't want to talk.
I don't want to talk about it.
Jeez. You're a little miss sensitive today.
Okay,
I
asshole.
Wish your luck, Warren. Not in the mood today.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
The movie booty. Excuse me? The what?
No, I've been way too busy with class and life.
Damn, girl, you had it like a year.
Or a week. I did browse through all the titles, drama queen.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
I don't know if I want to watch a movie named Cannibal Holocaust. That doesn't sound exactly like the, doesn't really, you know what? We haven't seen it yet.
No fucking way will I watch that. My mind is twisted enough.
Exactly.
I laughed my ass off.
Yeah, you're a menace to society.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
Faster pussycat kill.
No, I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill.
Russ Mayer was a genius of black and white. Plus, babes with breasts.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
Oh my
if
god,
I was lucky,
he's a Redditor, isn't he?
Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
Do we talk about it? Not yet. I feel like it's a little too early.
I don't want to speak about it. This is kind of a crazy day for me.
Yeah, we'll hold off on it for a bit.
I literally think I'm going crazy.
I may be a pest, but I'm a good listener.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathroom.
Oh, God.
You best tell me what you told the principal. Now. Answer me,
bitch. I told him the truth.
I told him the truth. A student had a gun.
No, you told him I had a gun. That's why he dragged me into his office.
Yeah, bitch.
And did what? Give you a stern lecture?
Nobody. Nobody lectures me. Everyone tries, though. They try.
Oh, God.
You should talk to somebody, Nathan.
He's a menace.
Do not analyze me. I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Oh, God. I could call the police, yeah.
I could call the police.
Do it. The Prescotts own the pigs here.
Get away from her, dude.
Oh, Warren.
Hey, leave him alone.
Nobody tells me what to do. Not my parents, not the principal,
that.
Or that whore
right
in the bathroom.
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren!
Oh, bro, I got this.
Oh, you really got that.
Get in there now. Don't even try to run. Nobody. Nobody.
Yeah, clearly you got that. Yeah, get him, Warren. Yeah, woo. Yeah, beat him up.
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous.
Oh, man.
This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. In 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
I have no idea. Hopefully nothing. Yeah, we'll go hopefully nothing.
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beatdown for you.
Warren?
Yeah.
Yeah, I owe him.
It's because he likes you, Max.
You're not the only one.
He has a crush. Ooh, woo.
You're causing trouble.
Oh, and Deb. Jesus Christ.
Here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I don't remember what the diary said. Yes.
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Only for Mark Jefferson. Oh, yeah, baby. Woo! Yeah!
Only for Mark Jefferson. He was a pretty famous photographer.
He's a sexy man, that's what it is.
I've always loved his work.
Yeah.
It was the can't do teach. I'm glad you found a good reason to come back.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
Oh. Give me a break.
Give me a break. I was going through changes. Like you.
I guess those changes included dumping me from your life.
That's not true, Chloe.
Oh, bullshit. Jesus Christ.
You thought you hook up with all these art pricks in Seattle. Didn't happen, though.
You're merciless.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Oh, no, way to make the car ride awkward. Awkward?
Broken? Man, are you serial?
Wow, haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
You can't even say serious?
Has a boatload of tools.
What?
Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific, tiny tools.
Bird alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
Well, that's kind of mean. Jesus Christ. Calling your father that? Hey, he could be a nice person. Don't be mean. Ooh, it's like the Toy Story house. Hey, Andy, where's Woody? Wait, what the fuck? Are we supposed to be in school? Did we just ditch it or something? What?
Come on in. Don't be shy.
Oh.
Still looks nice.
Home, shit, home.
That's cute.
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-fuhrer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
Ah, your step-fuhrer, huh? That's quite the loaded terminology. Also, you have pizza on the floor? What are you, a menace or something? Put the pizza on the table. There's a thing called sanitation. Anything below your knees is no longer sanitary. Alright,
When's the last time I had to dig through Chloe's crap?
What are we doing again? Turning on music?
And it reeks like dirty laundry. Gross.
Alright. Definitely not the duffel bag.
Oh, this is a flashback to youth. Our super secret closet lair.
So I assume Chloe is our big friend. Alright, nice. Where is our, people? Music? Ooh! The music!
It won't play without any power.
What the fuck? What is this, run off of like a backup generator or something? This entire house runs off of nothing but gasoline. Jesus Christ. Who the fuck actually turns off their shit? What? Who turns off the fucking power strip? Nobody does that. Do you do that? Nobody. Who are you? I mean, I guess this is 2013, you know, a time when nobody was rational. I guess it was just like Neanderthal land or something. It was like the Wild West. All right. Music? Here we go. Oh, God. I mean, yeah, well, lovely. Sorry. All right, continuing onward.
Houston, we have the power, but we need to find a disc to play.
We need to find a fucking CD now? Chloe, do you not have Spotify? Or YouTube? You know, YouTube came out like a couple years after 2013, right? There's a thing called that. Just play a music video. I hope to God that you don't start playing, like, Gangnam Style or something. Or, like Numa Numa. I don't know if the song was called Numa Numa, but, like, if I start hearing, like, Taylor Swift or Justin Bieber's Baby, I'm going to just flip my shit. All right. Now, where in tarnation is anything?
I think this junk swallowed her discs.
Damn! NSFW! Oh, God, we can't look at that. That's not safe for work. Oh, boobies! No, that one says SFW. It doesn't say NSFW on it, so it has to be safe. Boobies are pretty cool, not gonna lie. Alright, missing posters? Nice. We already know all about that.
So it was Chloe who printed all those flyers.
Ah! Maybe Chloe and Amber were best friends. Hmm, interesting. A box! Maybe it's got all their secret stuff on it. Oh, okay, or that too. Wait, that's a picture! That's a picture.
Hey, give me that.
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
Hmm. So, who is she? I guess we'll start off with that. We don't want to, like, dig too deep. Yeah.
So, who is she? Do you mind talking about her?
Rachel Amber. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, aww, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Okay, well,
I had no idea.
A little too far, but...
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot.
I never forgot. Even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
Ah, LA! I see! You know, that's where everybody likes to go. LA, the big city. You know, you go there to solve all of your world's problems. Clearly, it's a wonderful plan, and so many people love living in LA. Don't live there, by the way, it's awful. But actually, you know, maybe you do want to live there. There's nothing wrong with that, I guess, but... Alright, so what happened?
So what happened? Did your folks, your mom, try to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
Oh!
I feel the love.
Oh, God.
Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
How did you know?
How do you know she disappeared? Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life.
Unlike you, she would have told me, okay? Something happened to her.
I believe you. I'm just trying to get all deductive.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. And poof.
Oh,
and
well.
I haven't heard anything from her since.
Rip.
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
Man, that's fucking depressing as hell. Jesus Christ. Well, I'm sorry to hear that, Chloe. Wow. That's fucking loaded. Let's just put on some music. Alright, hit us with the fat tunes, baby. I swear to gosh, if it starts playing pumped up kicks, I'm gonna be so mad. all the other kids with the pumped up kicks. It's like, oh god, oh Jesus Christ. It's the best day ever. The SpongeBob soundtrack, I see.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
That's stupid.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
Ah, blaze it, hitting the 420s. You know what? I wish I could blaze it too, but I can't smoke. You know, asthma and all that. All right, now I guess...
I shouldn't bug Chloe now. Plus, I need those tools.
All right, time to fix our vintage camera. Our vintage Polaroid with a power drill. Ooh, is that Edward versus Jacob? Which one are you guys? Are you guys an Edward or a Jacob? Edward or Jacob? Is that what it is? Edward and Jacob? Or is it like Edward and James or something? Or like, I don't know, Edmund and Billy. I don't know. Alright. Let's go visit her lovely parents. Ooh, a door. Are they fucking? Oh,
this must be Chloe's
Jesus Christ.
Room. Man, I am nosy today.
Bird's dead. Jesus Christ.
Oh, shit. Poor thing. I bet I could do something to save it.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Open the window. Open the window. Bird, are you... This is why you don't slam into windows. All right. Now, CPR.
Oh, shit. Poor thing. I bet I could do something to save it.
Can we do CPR? Oh, wait, reversing. Right. Huh.
Dog tags. Sweet. David Mattson.
Why does he have dog tags? Is he dead or something? Ah, shit.
Act, react, or die. A 21st century survival guide.
Oh, God.
Whoa. Apocalypse self-help.
Oh, God. Is he one of those people that reads, like, zombie survival books? How to Survive the Zombie Apocalypse for Dummies or, like, you know, one of those books or something? Oh, God. He's a loser. Oh, God. We're going through the night drawer. We're going to find a sex toy in there.
Joyce has a little shrine to William.
Okay.
Her new husband may not be such a douche.
I was going to say. You open the side drawer, there's a dildo. It's like, oh, God. Jesus Christ. Please. I don't want that. All right, open.
Joyce still works at the diner. And Chloe's new dad is a security guard. Uh-oh.
Wait a minute. Security guard? Wait, is Chloe's dad the... Oh, he has to be that guy. Uh-oh, that's not good. Okay, wait. How do we save this bird? Wait. Right, you know, we're gonna go all the way back. Alright, the bird is going to be alive. Alright, open the window. Open the window. Blech. Woo! Now there's a bird in our room. How do we get you out? Good question.
You've been resurrected, birdie. Fly, be free.
Well, I guess they're building a nest in the house. Good luck. Not my problem. Alright, nice. Epic! Alright, let's go downstairs. Let's find the tools.
Nope. Someone locked it from the other side.
God damn it. Ooh. Alright. Tittle. Thanks, Max, again for helping me, smiley face. No problem. That guy's an asshole. Yeah. You know what?
Seen this place in
so are many
years.
People.
See, I should be able to find the tools I need here.
Aw, shit. I guess I skipped over a line of dialogue. Oopsies. Search. I need a small tool.
This is so lame.
Bro, you even look. Use this, those tools.
These are way too big. I need tiny tools for that camera.
Ah. Guess you need to go over to like Elf Town or something. Go over to the North Pole. I'm sure they have many tools for elves. Like an elf-sized screwdriver. Or buy an iFixit kit. Not sponsored. Okay, that's just a deer head. Beans! Beans! Sorry. Stupid. I'm dumb. Alright. We need to go into the tiny tool cabinet to find the tiny tools. A gun rack. Ooh! Can we find a shotgun and blast that one dude?
Chloe's stepfather is this asshole from Blackwell? You've gotta be shitting me.
Oh god. Oh god, he's a marine man. No wonder why he's an asshole.
Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell. He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? How paranoid can you get?
Huh? Can we close the cupboard? Uh-oh.
What the? Chloe's stepdad actually installed cameras in the rooms? For reals? This guy has serious trust issues. Do Chloe and Joyce even know about this?
Wait, is there one of Chloe's room? That would be super creepy if there is. Oh, God. So, does he film them fucking or something? That's kind of weird. Okay, let's look.
Wowzer, a map of Blackwell Academy.
What a creepy dude. Ew. Alright, we're gonna close that. Alright, we're not gonna open that. We're gonna close it. And I need to find the stupid freaking tools. Sir, where do you keep your mini tools? That's a cereal. And corned beef. What the fuck is corned beef, by the way? I've like never seen it. Okay, I don't want to look through this file. Where are the damn tools? I'm so confused.
No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway.
God damn it. Well, no one's home, right? We'll just snoop through it.
Shit! Butterfingers!
Uh-oh! Alright, no, we're gonna go back. Alright. We're not gonna pick up those files. Or actually... We're gonna look through those files.
Oh, man. I'll always make them fall.
And then we'll look through them.
Kate Marsh? Why the hell would he have pictures of her? Okay, this is getting totally...
Oh, God. Oh, God. Alright. Oh, God. Oh, that's creepy. Ew. He's going for the girls at the school. Ew. That's freaking weird. God. Are we gonna come across a pedophile? Oh, God. I really don't want to.
These are way too big.
Okay, where the fuck am I gonna find the tiny tools for the camera? I've been looking through this damn room for like a year and a half. Hello? Am I missing?
Boom, precision screwdrivers. Except I can't reach them.
Oh my god. Do I need like a step stool or something? Quick, we need to find the tools before the pedophile comes back. Oh god. Creepy weirdo, man! Is he home yet? It does not seem to be that way. Nice. The fuck? Okay, no, we're good. Now, how do we get that? A chair! No. A stool? No? How do we get that? Do we just stand on something? Wait, What do we turn on? Hey,
that
nice.
Was very smart, dumbass. No can reach.
Nice. And then we can get some cardboard. Ooh, the problem solving.
I should have done that before they fell.
You can't just like slide it around and get it out. Never mind then, I guess. Fine, fine. All right, nice. We put the cardboard. And then we do the thing. Epic! Nice! That's a weird laundry machine. Do you just kind of like turn it on like that? Wow, I know. Fucking Gen Z. Hello.
Yes, you fucking have mad skills, Max.
You gotta live with your technology. You know, back in my day, we used to have to use laundry machines. Blah, 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 blah. Shut up!
I should go back upstairs.
I don't know much about laundry machines, okay? I just know that, like, you set the timer and then you press the button and then it washes your clothes for you. God. I hope Mr. Weirdo Man doesn't, like, come after me or something. All right. Epic. Now, how do I... Where's my camera? Tools. How do you even fix one of these? I don't even know what the inside of one looks like. All technical and shit.
So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah. I just took them today.
Let me see. Wait. I've seen this before. No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life. Now tell me the truth, Max.
I was there. We gotta tell the truth.
Hiding in the corner. Damn, you're a ninja. A ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo.
That is so badass.
Aww, yeah, look at them bonding. It's so cute.
When I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
Nope.
Not at all. Your hair and clothes are so different.
I hope so. I'm sure this is all so weird to you after coming back.
Like you said, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
Just a bit.
Just a bit.
Little bit.
There's no way
tidbit.
You didn't hear every single vowel.
Okay. I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
Like who?
Like who?
Like anybody. Stop stalling, sister.
Uh-oh.
But he didn't seem to believe me.
The principal? Are you still 12?
Yes.
That drunk jackass only cares about cash for Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
I didn't mention you at all. Swear.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max.
Aww. They're so cute. This is a very long game, by the way. Goddamn. Episode 1? More like fucking season 1 at this point. Jesus.
I know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Man, that's a vintage-ass camera.
My dad would be pissed if I never used it. And now I know it'll be used awesomely.
Aww.
And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
It's so cute.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the
way. Hey, me!
Like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
You're mushy crazy. Shit. Hell yeah.
Fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance. Shake that bony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera.
Aw, they're so cute. Yeah! Where's my camera? Photo.
This day couldn't get any stranger.
Woo! Yeah! Hell yeah! Like something straight out of the 60s. So what, you'd be taking pictures of Elvis with that camera.
Can't dance, hippie, come on. Rock out, girl.
Alright. Time to be a monkey jumping on the bed.
Break it down, Max.
One fell down and bumped his head.
Yo, turn it off. Turn it off.
How many times have I told you to stop blasting that punk shit?
Dude, the music's not even on. Asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, no fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Uh-oh.
What's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay?
Max, oh God!
Find a place to hide now.
Chloe,
I'm coming.
What are you doing?
Hide in the closet.
Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just let me in now.
Please. Second, my bra is stuck.
I'm not screwing around, soldier.
I'm not a kid anymore. I can't hide under the bed. Where else?
I'm giving you exactly 3 seconds to open the door. One, two.
This is going nowhere fast.
God damn it.
I better look someplace else.
What's going on in here? Why is she here?
None of your business.
God dang it.
I don't like strangers here.
Stop freaking. She's not a stranger. This is my friend.
Great. Another one of your friends.
Oh, what an asshole. Sam, we can't find any place to hide, really? Darn.
One of my guns is missing. Did you take it?
Oh, God. I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control.
Wait. Is that grass? You been toking up again in here?
Oh yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth. That's an order.
It's not my pot. It's from Max.
Excuse me?
Is this true?
I don't want to take the blame. We can redo the choice, right? Excuse me? Yeah, that's grass. You know what? Ah, I'll take the blame. We'll do it for now.
Yeah. My pot.
So you're bringing drugs into my home. How about if I call the police? That'd screw up your spotless Blackwell record.
Ooh.
You seem to get around, Max. I'm sick of you losers dragging Chloe down.
Jesus Christ.
I see, you sure do like to pop up and start trouble. Like this afternoon. You don't have anything smart to say now, do
Get
you?
Get the hell away from her, man. Stop harassing my friends.
You don't have any friends.
Like you know. You're not even a real cop. You're a fucking security guard.
Oh.
I was a soldier, Chloe. And Max, if I see you here again, you'll learn all about real trouble.
Oh, what an asshole.
Thanks for taking the heat. We totally...
Jesus Christ, what an asshole.
Down, Max. He's no match for you and me now. That was an epic win.
What an asshole.
Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can hang in this hick hole.
I hope that didn't have any consequences.
Man, that did not go well for me.
Yeah, or
if
doctor.
If you open the window, we can both get the hell out of here.
Yeah. What happens if we go back? I want to go all the way back. I want to see what happens if we go back. Okay, that one doesn't seem like a terrible option.
Chloe,
I'm coming.
Alright, I want to see if we can hide.
Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Smart. Just let me in.
Move.
Please.
1 second. My bra is stuck.
I'm not screwing around, soldier. Chloe, open this
door. Oh, there we go, baby. Oh, yeah, we're hiding now. Hell yeah.
I'm giving you a...
Shit.
What's going on in here?
Jesus, I'm just trying on clothes. You're so friggin' paranoid.
Yeah. Combat, we'll do that to you.
Oh my God, what a fucking loser.
One of my guns is missing. Did you take it?
Oh God, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control?
Wait, is that grass? You been toking up again in here?
Oh yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth, that's an order. Whose is it?
Stay hidden. She wants us to stay hidden, right?
stop treating me and my mom like we're your family platoon.
Hey, leave Joyce out of this.
Oh, God.
I wish you'd leave Joyce, like now.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Chloe, I'm sorry. I care about your mother.
Oh,
just keep pushing me.
Don't touch me again, asshole. That's the last time. Or I'll bring the cops in here so fast.
You're not that dumb.
I'd be smart to have you busted.
Chloe, someday you'll grow up.
Hey, you okay?
Welcome to the real step douches of Arcadia Bay.
Jesus Christ.
I'm sorry.
For what? He would have been a bigger dick if he caught you in here.
That's hard to believe.
Anyway, let's sneak out the window.
Yeah, I don't want him to do anything to me, too. Chloe seems a little bit different.
David was such a mean bastard to Chloe. What if I had stepped up to help?
No, though you would have taken more of the blame, and then he would have gone after you, and then, like, everything would be bad.
Damn, what are you waiting for? Open the window.
Ah! We make Chloe unhappy, and I don't like that. Because I feel like if we stepped in, it would have been the same that, like, blame myself for the... But she did blame us for the weed. I think this way. We'll be better this way. There we go. Jesus Christ. Actually scary. We're hitting some real consequences here. Wild. What the fuck? Ooh, a deer! Oh, deer! Wow, that is a low-quality deer. Low res as hell.
I haven't been here in forever. So why do I feel like I was just here?
Because you were here, in a hurricane.
This is the exact same path I was on during my nightmare today.
It's God's wrath. Alright, a sign. It says, go to the lighthouse. Interesting. Oh, trash can. God damn it. Alright. Moving onwards, I guess. Ooh, right. I guess it's where. You have to tell me your big secret. Equal Keck. Alright, nice. Sounds like 2013 lingo to me.
Birds are so lucky, they can always escape.
Hey, that's the boat that got smashed into the lighthouse. Oh, interesting. Alright, nice.
Wowzer, Chloe drew that to mark our tree fort, so we'd always be able to find each other in case of emergency.
Aww. Max, it's okay. It's okay. Ooh, campfire!
Looks like the youth of Arcadia Bay still come up here to party. I never made it.
Honestly, Max, it's okay. You know what? Partying is for babies anyways.
How long has that been here?
Trust no one. Well, that's a little bit kind of mean. It's okay. Ooh, haiku. Turn this way now. Face the lonely autumn tree. And never look back. Turn this way now. Or face the lonely autumn tree. And never look back. The lonely autumn tree. Autumn. Are we even in autumn? What season of the... It's October, right? So we're autumn. Lonely autumn tree. Oh, that one. Alright, now we're facing it. Now, what's the next step? And never look back. Ah, shit, I think we did anyways. Oopsies. My bad. Alright. Graffiti.
Clearly, the Bigfoots are everywhere.
Nah, indeed. I love Bigfoot. Alright, never mind. Clearly not. Woo!
Weird. Those glyphs remind me of the wind.
The wind? I feel like those glyphs remind me of... Egypt. Yeah. All right, let's find out what's inside.
Too bad it's locked.
God damn it.
I remember racing up and down the steps.
All right, what do I need to do? Where's my brick of C4? Or C2 for the... I don't know. All right. Now, what are we doing here again? Oh, wait, Chloe's here. Oopsies. Kind of forgot about that, actually. My bad.
Sure you don't want to be alone?
Sit down if you want.
You pissed at me?
Are you pissed at me?
I just wanted some backup.
I'm not as brave as you. And David is in...
You didn't tell me to hide!
I'm sorry you had to experience it firsthand.
You have to live with him. Has he always been this way?
Ever since my desperate mom dragged his ass to our home, I never trusted David.
Hmm.
He freaked out on poor Kate Marsh today.
I know her. She's cool. Only that prick would bully her.
He has some kind of weird agenda.
He has a lot of secret files. Rambo still thinks he's gathering enemy intelligence. Did you take a peek?
Well, yeah, I couldn't help it.
Never change. What did you find?
Found all? Yep. Ooh.
Other Blackwell students.
This dude takes his job too seriously. He still thinks he's at war or something. He's a total surveillance fetish. Where are there spy cams in the house?
Ooh, there are.
Chloe, your house is under surveillance.
What are you talking about?
There are cameras all over the house. I saw it on a monitor in the garage.
I knew it. He's so hella fucking paranoid. I'll keep this a secret for now.
This is how we get mom to divorce him.
No wonder I'm so miserable. Everybody in this town knows everybody's secrets.
What's Nathan's secret?
What's Nathan's secret?
He's an elite asshole who sells bad shit cut with laxative. And he dosed me with some drug in his room.
Oh, God.
What?
Oh, no.
Some shovel bar that didn't card me. He was too rich for the place and too wasted, and he kept flashing bills.
Just tell me what happened, Chloe.
Oh, no. Oh.
I was an idiot. I thought he was so blazed it would be an easy score.
You needed money that bad?
Actually, yes.
Oh.
And I thought I'd have enough for me and Rachel if she showed up.
Oh, God. What about Nathan?
So, what about you and Nathan?
We went to his room at Blackwell. We drank, and I laughed at his rich kid bullshit.
Oh, God.
I was one step ahead and put something in my beer.
God, Chloe. I can't believe this. I mean, I do. Then what?
I know I passed out on the floor.
Oh.
I woke up and that perv was smiling, crawling towards me with a camera.
Go on.
Everything was a blur. I tried to kick him in the balls and broke a lamp. Nathan freaked, so I managed to bum rush the door and get the hell out. Max, it was insane.
Ah, Jesus Christ.
Chloe, that is so fucked up. What did you do then?
I figured I would make him pay me to keep quiet. So we met in the bathroom.
And he brought a gun.
That was Nathan's last mistake.
He's still dangerous.
He's still dangerous, Chloe. Not just to you.
Oh, good thing you notified the principal. I feel safer already.
I won't always be there to save you.
You were here today, Max. You saved me. I'm still tripping on that. Seeing you after all these years feels like...
destiny.
If this is destiny, I hope we can find Rachel. I miss her, Max. This shit pit has taken away everyone I've ever loved. I'd like to drop a bomb on Arcadia Bay and turn it to fucking glass.
Okay, calm down, the prophet of truth. Holy shit. Oh God. Oh God, now we're back. Now we're back. Hello, Hurricane Katrina.
Why is this happening to me?
How could this happen to me?
Why am I here again?
I made my mistakes. Have nowhere to run. What are we doing again? We're in a hurricane. All right, let's move. There does not seem to be anybody behind. There's a deer.
Is Chloe still up there?
Chloe!
Find out.
Okay. Well, clearly, not the side to go up. Alright. Jesus Christ!
Help! Help!
Alright, how do we go under? Over? Around? Some way? Something?
I've never seen a storm like this in Oregon. Whee!
Alright, nice! We're doing pretty good, baby. The deer! Oh dear. Alright. Come on, Mr. Deer. Uh-oh. Okay. Well, that was simple. I almost made it the first time around. Alright, nice. We're doing pretty good. Hitting them with the nice puzzles. Alright, Mr. Deer.
Oh my lord! The tornado is back!
Jesus Christ! Help! Help! Help, Lord of Mercy! Help!
Alright. What?
Lord of Mercy, my soul!
Oh god. Oh god. Okay.
Oh. Oh. Oh.
Oh, we're doing pretty good, baby. Alright. Read. Read.
October 11th? Is this Friday?
Oh, no! And no one knows about this freak hurricane?
Oh.
Well.
And a tornado is headed straight for the town.
Uh-oh. That's not... Holy Jesus Christ.
Chloe, you're here. I'm back. Oh, my lord. This is real. It's real. Oh, man. This sucks.
Max, what's going on? You totally blacked out.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Oregon gets about 5 tornadoes every 20 years. We just zone.
No, no. I saw it. I could actually feel the electricity in the air.
Come on. Take a breath, okay?
Chloe, I'm not crazy. But there's something else I have to tell you. Something hardcore.
Talk to me, Max.
I had this same vision earlier in class. When I came out of it, I discovered I could reverse time. Like I said, not crazy.
But I, right?
Listen to me. How do you think I saved you in the bathroom?
By reversing time? Yeah, sure.
I saw you get shot, Chloe. Saw you actually die. I was able to go back and hit the fire alarm.
Okay, I see you're a geek now with a great imagination, but this isn't anime or a video game. People don't have those powers, Max.
I don't know what I have, but I have it. And I'm scared shitless.
Prove it right now.
It's been a hell insane fucking day.
It's snowing?
What the hell is this?
Snowflakes?
It's like 80 degrees. How?
Uh-oh.
Climate change.
Climate change.
Storm is coming.
Ah, of course.
Max, start from the beginning. Tell me everything.
How did this happen? Climate change. Understandable. Have a nice day. Jesus Christ. Aww. Oh man, Jesus Christ. Well, that was super good. Jesus. Holy fuck. And that was it for episode 1 of Life is Strange.